Government contracting involves a cast of characters that all play different roles in the procurement process. If you want to be an effective salesperson and advocate for your small business, you need to know who to talk to when to win contracts and help your company grow. Complaints that I hear from small business owners in the government contracting space is that they can't get a contracting officer or small business specialist to call them back. This is certainly an extremely annoying part of doing business, and there are just some people who are unprofessional and won't get back to you. However, more often than not, these people aren't getting a response because they're either contacting the wrong person, not providing enough information, or both. Fair or not, many government employees in the procurement space are swamped and simply can't get back to people who don't know how to use the system properly. So, to help you navigate that system and start getting the responses you're looking for, here's a quick guide to the four key players in contracting, who to talk to when, and how to get them on your side. In any given procurement, there will be an end user, a program manager, a contracting officer, and a small business specialist. The end user is just that, the person who will eventually work with the product or solution. If you happen to be able to speak to the end user to understand a bit more about the problem so that you can provide the best solution, great. But these are not the people with procurement authority. The same tends to go for the program manager, though this may vary depending on the size of the procurement. If you sell computers, for example, the end user is the worker who will be typing away each day, while the program manager is the manager of the department that needs new computers. The contracting officer and the small business specialist are the two players that most small businesses should and do focus on. And they're also the two that most small businesses do not utilize appropriately or effectively. The contracting officer is the person responsible for the procurement. They should know the details of what needs to be purchased, all the specifications, costs, etc., though they may need to check with the program manager for some of these answers if it's a technical procurement. The contracting officer should be your primary point of contact. They make the decisions. The small business specialist, however, represents the Office of Small and Disadvantaged Business Utilization and is there to be your advocate. But let me clarify that statement real quickly. When I say your advocate, I mean an advocate for all small business, not for your particular company. They don't know the details of specific procurements necessarily, and they do not make purchasing decisions. And this is where many small businesses get tripped up. Treating a small business specialist as you would a contracting officer is one quick way to not get what you want. If you're interested in selling your product or service, responding to sources sought notices or RFPs, or doing any of the other straightforward tasks associated with federal government contracting, go through the CO. If you have an issue with the CO that you think disadvantages you as a small business, then you involve the small business specialist. Additionally, when you need to involve the small business specialist, make sure that you're clear about what happened and make it easy for the small business specialist to help you. Send an email. If you want to call and email, fine, but you have to email so that your communication is trackable. Make sure that you include your name and contact information, the information about the procurement, including the solicitation number, what the issue is, and where more information can be found. You need to always remember that these people are busy and they're bound by certain regulations. It's your responsibility to make it easy for them to help you so that they can address your problem. It's also your responsibility to communicate effectively so that they can advocate for you. Phone calls from 100 people stating their names and numbers and that they have an issue are not effective. They're not attached to a solicitation or a person, and it's simply not feasible to call everyone back. However, 100 emails, or honestly, even just 10 emails, that clearly identify an issue so that complaints about a particular CO or a particular procurement can be documented and addressed are effective. Send these emails to the CEO and copy the small business specialist. The government contracting world is a frustrating place. However, knowing who to talk to when can drastically improve a small business's effectiveness. I hope this explanation of the cast of characters will help your business more effectively interact with the procurement players and to win contracts. For more tips, tricks, and tutorials, as well as the latest entrepreneurship news, make sure to follow me on Twitter and subscribe to this channel right here on YouTube.